Hello, and welcome to the technique video for your chromatography lab. Before we get started, let's go over the safety information. You need to wear goggles whenever chemicals are out. Acetone and the alcohols used in this lab can irritate the skin and eyes, so if any contact occurs, thoroughly rinse the area with water. Refer to the safety video if you are unsure how to use the eyewash. We'll go through the disposal guidelines at the end of the video. For exercise 1, you will need the 3 organic solvent mixtures in your water. The deionized water comes out of the faucet with the white handle, 1 of each of the 5 dyes, 4 beakers, a bottle of an unknown, 4 thin layer chromatography plates, enough capillary tubes for each of the dyes plus the unknown, a pencil, and a ruler. Begin by setting up your solvent chambers. Each group will prepare 4 TLC plates. So you will need 4 solvent chambers. Add 1 solvent to each of the 4 beakers. You don't need very much. Cover each beaker with cellophane or plastic wrap. Let these sit while you prepare your TLC plates. Use a pencil to lightly mark a line about 1 centimeter from the bottom of the plate. Do not dig the pencil lead into the plate. It will chip it and interfere with adding the dyes. Use a capillary tube to spot each known dye and the unknown mixture onto the TLC plate. Make sure your spots are small and well spaced out. Instead of spotting all of the dyes onto one plate before moving on to the next, line up several plates and spot them all at once to finish faster. Figure out a system that will let you keep track of which spot goes with each dye. Place each plate in a beaker with the spotted line at the bottom. The level of the solvent in the beaker should be below the line that you drew with your pencil. The solvent will begin moving up the TLC plate and will carry the dyes with it at different rates. You might need to add more solvent if the level gets low. Simply flip the plate forward so that the plastic part is facing where you are pouring the solvent so that your stationary phase doesn't get splashed. Keep an eye on the plates and pull them out when the solvent appears to stop moving, or if the solvent is getting near the top of the plate. Your data will not be accurate if the solvent reaches the top. Allow the plates to air dry and prepare your notebook to record the data you need to calculate the retention factor, or RF value. I would prepare a table like this in your notebook that will help you organize your data. A quick sketch or picture of each of your plates would help you remember what they looked like and what you measured for the RF value when you are preparing for the midterm report and the final. Use your pencil to mark any areas of color that are faint or hard to see. Mark the solvent line, the highest level that the solvent reached on the plate. Measure from the line that you made along the bottom in the beginning up to the solvent line and record this value. Then measure between the line you made in the beginning and the darkest part of each spot and record these values. The RF value can be calculated by dividing the distance to spot travel by the distance to solvent travel. You should calculate 1 RF value for each known dye. Your unknown contains 2 dyes and will therefore have 2 spots, so you should calculate 2 separate RF values for your unknown. You will calculate these values for each spot on each of your 4 plates. The purpose of doing 4 TLC plates was to find the solvent that works best for your unknown. If you compare these 3 separations made using different solvents, which one would allow you to best isolate each component of the mixture? One where the dots are close together or on top of each other, or one where the dots are spread out? Once you have decided which solvent gives you the best separation for your unknown, move on to exercise 2. You'll need silica gel, sand, glass wool, a small wooden rod, a pasteur pipette, and 2 scupulas. You will take the glass wool and bunch it up to form a plug. Then use the wooden rod to press it down to the bottom of the pasteur pipette. It should be tight enough that the stationary phase does not go through, but loose enough so that it allows the mobile phase to flow through. Add a little bit of sand. Then add silica gel until it is about a half inch from the top of the pipette. All of the procedure up to this point can be done while waiting for your TLC plates to finish. There's that working in parallel. Take the solvent that gives the best separation and add enough of the solvent so that the entire column is wet and you can see the liquid is above the top of the silica gel. The solvent should not be allowed to go below the level of the silica gel during this exercise, but to put the unknown on the column, you should allow the meniscus to just touch the silica gel and then add 2 drops of your unknown. Then immediately add a little more sand on top of the silica gel and add some more solvent. At this point, I would recommend calling your TA over just to make sure everything's set up correctly before you continue. If they say it looks okay, Continue adding solvent to keep the level above the silica gel and continue to exercise 3. At first, the clear colorless solvent will be dripping out of the pipette. You should use a waste beaker to collect this so that it doesn't drip all over the lab bench. Once the colored solution starts to drip out, swap the waste beaker for a clean, dry 50 milliliter beaker that you will use to collect the first colored solution. Once the drops go back to being colorless, switch back to collecting the drops in the waste beaker. When another color starts to come through, place a new empty beaker underneath the pipette and collect it. Repeat this for each dye that is present. Your lab manual tells you what to do if two colors are eluting at the same time. Once you have collected each fraction, take a small portion from each and place it in a separate cuvette. Dilute it up to the mark with deionized water. Use the spectrophotometer to collect a UV visible spectrum from 800 to 200 nanometers. You will take the cuvettes with the colored solution along with the blank, a cuvette filled with deionized water. Open the scan program and select Setup. Make sure it is set to record from 800 to 200 nanometers. Hit OK. Take your blank cuvette and a Kim wipe and clean the two sides of the cuvette that the light will pass through. Place it in the spectrophotometer and close the lid. Press 0 on the computer. Take out the blank, then pick one of your cuvettes with the colored solution in it. Clean two sides, the ones that the light will pass through, then place it in the spectrophotometer. Select Start in the program, name your file and sample, then allow the spectrophotometer to collect data. Repeat this for each cuvette. You will compare the spectra that you measure with the spectra for each dye. These will be available in Canvas. Think about how you can use these results to determine how pure each of your components were. When you are finished with the lab and are ready to clean up, make sure that you throw everything away in the right places. The solvents used today need to be poured into the waste containers located in the fume hood. Solid waste, like the TLC plates, can be thrown away in the regular trash can. To dispose of the capillary tubes, blot out the excess dye onto a paper towel, then throw them away in the glass disposal. The microcolumn should be placed in the glass disposal. You don't need to clean everything out of the inside, just throw it away. That's all for this week's technique video, and I will see you all next week.